ISUPK.
Get up by the hand, man. He a Hebrew Israelite. But understanding you a Hebrew Israelite, you got to follow certain rules.
I follow, brother.
And one of the rules is, thou shalt not shave your beard off. You can't cut your hair off. Give me the scripture I need in the book of Leviticus. You understand? So that's why we out here, so we can teach our brothers, man. You understand? We understand that the Hebrew Israelite culture is shaking the earth. Well, we gonna come out here and teach according to the Bible what you should do and what you shouldn't do. You understand? Give me what I need.
We're in the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 27. You shall not round the corners of your head.
Should not do what?
Round the corners of your head.
Meaning you shouldn't get a line of like the filthy, disgusting Egyptian.
Yeah.
That's the culture of another nation. You understand? So why you shouldn't shave your face, brother? You should. You look at these brothers with these beards. They got glorious beards out here. So when you shave your face off, you sin against the Most Power that created the heavens and the earth. And when you break the law of the Most High, we suffer the worst out of all the nations, out of the 18 nations that's in the earth. We suffer the most.
That's
no. I'm gonna go. I got you. Read, keep reading, priest.
Should thou mar the corners of thy beard.
So your beard, you didn't cut your beard off because you've been in hell and under captivity under the so-called white man for so long. You've grown accustomed to sinning against the Most High. And because we do that, we suffer on the bottom of every other nation in the Bible. You understand? Give me Amos 3:1 real quick. You understand? And I'm going to show you the punishment. And I'm going to justify why black, Hispanic, and Native American Indians are on the bottom right now. Listen to this one scripture, you go about your business. Listen to this one scripture. And this is why we out here. Did y'all make sure the brother got a flyer? You understand? We're going to teach you the truth according to the Bible. We ain't going to teach you a lie and teach you how to sing and dance and all that garbage. We out here cutthroat and going to show you what's really in the scriptures. But because Martin Luther King, your Christian pastors, you understand, like the brothers bringing out, whoever was in Islam, Malcolm X, Farrakhan, they did such of a, excuse my French, they did such of a worse job, you understand? I don't even know what the word to use, man. I'm trying to hold my tongue. They failed at the job. You see what I'm saying? And because of that, you look at the condition of black, Hispanic, and Native American Indian people, they on the bottom. They failing. Why? Because your Christian leaders, your leaders failed you. You understand? Give me Amos 3:1 real quick so I can show you this. And after that, we're going to Psalms 147. Read.
The book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you.
Has spoken against who?
Against you.
So the Most High is speaking against the children of Israel right here. You see my point? You say your beard, the Most High is speaking against you. You descend from the 12 tribes of Israel, and you out there, you a hoe and a whoremonger, the Lord is against you. You out there eating shrimp, crab, lobster. You out there celebrating the holidays of the other nations. The Lord is against you. And he's speaking against us right now. But you, I just highlighted something you is doing, though. I just proved it to the scriptures. Well, that's a...
That's a sin.
Read.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
So who did the Most High bring out the land of Egypt? You understand? You black, Hispanic, and Native American Indian people. That's right here catching the bus. The Most High brought your ancestors out of the land of Egypt. What does Egypt mean? That's a Greek word for bondage. Meaning you in captivity under another nation. You understand? This is the truth.
I gotta catch this bus.
Nah, yeah, I know. Come on, stay on.
You only have I known.
You what?
You only have I known.
So the Most High only made one nation, man. And then that's the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. You understand? We come out here with this truth and show you what you're supposed to be doing according to the Bible. You know what y'all do? You leave off. Because why? We in America, which is the daughter of harlots. You understand? You understand? America lets you be a homosexual. America lets you marry your goddamn dog in the courthouse. You understand that? Man on man, man, you're behind you. You understand? Esau does not dictate a marriage. You know what marriage is, sis? Yeah, what is marriage? According to the Bible. I'm gonna tell you right now, marriage is sex. Give me Genesis 24:67. So we're gonna prove it according to what we said, because the scriptures say, if any man speak, he gotta speak as the oracles of God. You understand? What are the oracles of God? The truth. When we bring it out right here on the street corner, your Christian pastor never teach you. You understand? Genesis 24:67. We're gonna show you marriage according to the Bible. You understand? Let's go.
In the book of Genesis, chapter 24, verse 67.
Right.
And Isaac brought her into his mother Sarah's tent.
So Isaac brought her into the tent, meaning a house. You understand? Something with a roof over it. You understand? And we're going to find out what Isaac did. Read.
And took Rebekah, and she became his wife.
She did what?
She became his wife.
They went into the tent and got it on, and she became his wife. She didn't need a ring from the white man. She didn't need, you understand, a white man's certificate to validate a marriage.
Right.
So when you put your rod in a woman, that's marriage according to the Bible.
Right.
You understand? Yeah, let's get one more for the sister. You understand? 21:10, and then also give me Deuteronomy 21:10. I know y'all used to look at the sister. She
was shocked, like, damn, I ain't never heard this in my life.
But we in the Holy Bible. You see that? This is the Holy Bible. This is not our words. This is the Most High words. You understand? And guess what? These scrolls right here was not given to nobody but us.
What?
You understand? Black, Hispanic, and Native American Indian people. It wasn't given to the white man. It wasn't given to the Chinese man. The word holy means to be separate. And the sister is blown away. Look at her, y'all. You know what I'm saying? She like, God, I never heard this in my life. That's how I felt when I first heard the truth. But guess what? The Christian church has brainwashed you, sis. You brainwashed. And guess what? We out here to unbrainwash you. You understand? Huh? You not Christian? Okay. All right, no shit. I hear you. So, you Muslim? You don't know what you is? So that's, you got the correct fire in your hand. We're going to teach you what you is. You understand? Read what you got.
In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 21, verse 11. And seeing among the captives.
Seeing among what?
The captives.
Who are the captives? Who are the captives in America right now? Huh? The captives are you so-called black people that's catching the bus, that's on the bottom, going to work for the so-called white man, struggling, barely getting housing. You understand? The first fired, the last hired. You understand? You're getting high out your mind. Stop getting high, black people. That's what you got to do first. See what I'm saying? Stop smoking that goddamn weed. A weed make a man weak. You understand? We build a strong man up in the ISUPK under Commander Junior Hunter, man. Throw the weed in the goddamn garbage, man. You understand? Give it to your brothers. Weed.
A beautiful woman.
A what?
A beautiful woman and has desire unto her.
God has desire.
quiet, man. I said, I want to engage and true according to the Bible. That's what I got to do first. And that's established in the UPK. It's a one-year rule in the UPK. You understand? You got a quarter system, man. See what she about. You understand? Read on. That thou wouldest have her to thy wife.
Thou's would have had her as what?
To thy wife.
So, hey, if we court for 6 months, and I get us, and we decide to do that thing, that sister is my wife. You understand? I'm going to pass it to the next powerful priest. Keep reading. Salakia.
Then thou shalt bring her home to thine house.
Then you should bring to your house. Keep going.
And she shall shave her head.
She said what?
Shave her head. And pare her nails. And she shall put the raiment of her captivity from off her. And shall remain in thine house.
That's a remain where?
In thine house. And beware her father and her mother a full month. And after that, thou shalt go in unto her.
Thou shalt go into her. So how can I go into a woman? I go into her with my wife, Salaki. I gotta say it like, you know what I mean? How do I take a woman? By putting my rod in her. That validates marriage. Not no goddamn ring and a certificate from the white man. You understand? So we out here, I'm brainwashing our people. You understand? And we showing you, according to the Bible, that the white man puts on our people since slavery, that this is the absolute truth. The problem is, we don't know the truth because we've been following who? Martin Luther King. Like the brother's been blazing Martin Luther King all day. Malcolm X all day. You understand? T.D. Jakes and all that. You know what I'm saying? That's what we out here fighting against, man. The brainwashing that's been pushed on our people. And the number one component to bring our nation back together is brotherhood, man. You understand? Lord, our brother is thyself. Lord, the Most High, with all your soul, heart, and might, man. You understand? Those are the two commandments that will bring our nation back together.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs. I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, but it's guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword.